In this episode of Video Marketing Mastery, I want to teach you something that I do all the time. It's changed the trajectory of my business and for my clients. And I'm going to explain how to use video to boost the ROI from conferences and how to optimize the way your sales team convinces and converts all year long. You know, most businesses spend 95% of their time dealing with a pre-conference strategy and only 5% of the time on post-conference where all of the revenue is generated from. And because people process information in a video 60,000 times faster than they do with text, because people are 3 times more likely to share video, and video also has an increased memory recall, because we process it quicker, we have a higher memory recall, it's such a valuable tool for educating people and getting them to buy. So when you're at a conference, I want you to think about this 5%, which is the post-conference strategy, and how you incorporate the power of video into that. While you're at a conference, KOLs, your key opinion leaders, or maybe clients, maybe even your best salespeople, they should all be in the same building right around the same time. And that's when you should consider creating videos, because there's an important part of the follow-up strategy that I'm going to explain in a few moments. Now, at your booth, if your booth is laid out and it's got 4 sides, then each side of your booth is a conversion opportunity. And I go to maybe 20 or 25 conferences a year. And the teams that I see that do it the best are the ones where on one side of their booth, they have an espresso bar, right? Or maybe at around 4 o'clock, it turns into a cocktail bar. And at the other side of the booth, they've got swag and maybe food on the other corner. And then on the the far outside corner of their booth, if there's 4 sides, they're giving out invites to that night's event. And everybody around the booth is given a badge scan. And these badge scan devices, they kind of look like a mobile phone. But when you've got your lanyard, the salesperson or the marketing rep at the booth should go over and scan them before they give them coffee or espresso or some swag or food or an invite to their event, because the whole conference is about getting people into your database so you can nurture those leads at higher and higher levels and convert them. And that's where video comes in and the value of capturing those leads. Now, while your key opinion leaders are there, or your best salesperson who's already learned how to optimize the process of answering common pushbacks and objections, or even you've got somebody who's a client that's got a great case study, peel them off into a side room 1 hour at a time, capture and record those videos so you can produce them and then use them in an email follow-up strategy that'll happen after the conference. Now, what I want you to do with these videos is I want you to post each video onto its own article page on your website. Because once you do that, then Google can index that page individually. It can be found by search. And then your sales team can know how to access those later on. We'll teach you that in just a second. So stay with me. Then what you're going to want to do, instead of posting a YouTube video and embed the YouTube video on your website like people have done historically, you're going to want to use a Wistia video player. And you're going to connect that video player to your Salesforce. Or even you can Frankenstein it between HubSpot and Salesforce and the Wistia video player, and it's going to get you actionable data. So if you meet 2,000 people at your booth, or let's say you're speaking and there's 1,000 people in the audience and you get them badge scanned somehow, those people will all get an email out, and when they watch the videos, those tools, Wistia, HubSpot, Salesforce, will provide actionable data to your sales team, so you'll know of all the people you met at the conference who's showing a high level of interest. And you can't do this with text, but you can do it with video. So if somebody watches, like let's say over 80% of one of your videos, it should send an email to your sales rep for them to follow up, and they can then start focusing on the people that are ready to convert. Instead of cold leads, they're focusing on hot leads. So remember, Wistia, Salesforce, HubSpot, it'll help you get actionable data. And then you can email them out, like I mentioned. And then throughout the rest of the year, what you're going to want to do is you're going to show your sales team how to take those individual videos on individual article pages. And if a prospect handles them with a common objection, gives them a common objection, or maybe asks for a case study, then they just email them a link to the appropriate page where that information is. Now, naturally, what I want you to do is answer that question in person first. But then when they get back to their computer or to their mobile device, send an email with that video that answers that question, because it reinforces the validity of the salesperson. And that's how you boost ROI at a conference, by creating videos. You optimize the way you're convincing and converting leads that you're getting at that conference. And then throughout the year, your sales team can use those same assets to nurture and boost ROI, because you ultimately, at the end of the day, you want your ROI to look like a hockey stick. And that's how you use video to do it.
For the full version of this podcast and other free episodes, find Video Marketing Mastery on iTunes. Subscribe today, and we'll keep you up to date on everything you need to know to become a marketing master.